Dear students, let us continue our study in this paper entitled Questioned Document. And when we are analyzing documents, alteration in documents is very important component that as forensic scientists you have to investigate. So this particular module shall deal with alteration in documents and focusing on the addition and overwriting, that is alteration in documents due to the addition and overwriting done. After studying this module, you will be able to know what is meant by the term alteration in context to document. You shall be able to learn the differences between addition and deletion. And you shall be able to identify and examine the alteration in documents. Alteration, if you try to know, is defined as any change to a document which gives it a different effect from that it originally possessed. And if the change is made after execution of a document and without the consent of the other party or concerned person, then such change is called as fraudulent alteration. The alteration can be done by addition or interlineations or by overwriting. It can also be done by erasing, but that topic we will be taking in the next module. Let us try to know what are the features of fraudulent alteration. These alterations are done in such a way that they may pass unnoticed under the regular or the routine examination of the document. And another thing that you have to keep in mind is the alteration methods are usually latent or may be so minute that an unskilled or incompetent examiner may not be even able to detect them. So let us talk about these in details and let us begin with how the addition in the document is done for frauds. Addition in the document, if you look for definition, it is defined as the insertion of any word or digit, etc., which changes the meaning or value of the document. These insertions are made in such spaces which may have been left blank in the regular entries, either in the middle or mostly at the bottom of the page. If additional matter is written in a small space, the size of letters will be smaller and writing will appear cramped. Or if space is large enough, then the letters are in large sizes to cover up the remaining space. In the addition alteration, the examination can be done to identify the characteristic features of handwriting, like size of the letter, spacing and pen strokes, and color ink should be made. That is, looking at the size of the letter and spacing and pen strokes, which are normal, wherever there is some change, wherever there is something which has been added, can be easily identified. Similarly, color of the ink, because originally if the script or whatever that document is there has been written with one particular ink, obviously after some time when it is altered by addition, then that particular added component will have a different color of ink. Even if it is blue, you have studied that in the inks you can classify them and identify whether they are of the same pen or different by various techniques. So you will be able to know that whether the color of the ink was same in the entire document or some part which have been added, and because of addition the alteration has been made, how that particular different ink has been used for doing that particular addition. So I repeat here that in addition alteration, the examination focus will be there to identify the characteristic features of handwriting, that is, originally if it is unaltered, then the size of letter, the spacing and pen strokes will be uniform. If there is some change, then that is a hint towards the alteration. Similarly, the color of ink, if the entire document is in the same color and with the same ink, and even the aging of ink can be looked into, that will be giving you idea, and you'll be able to better analyze that whether that particular document has been altered or not by addition. In order to study and understand this more, let us look at a case study related to alteration by addition. The alteration of document by addition can be best understood by the following case study. A case was submitted which required determining whether an entry in a diary that read meeting 2 p.m. signing when. It was all written sequentially on one occasion. The examination revealed that the words meeting, 2 p.m. and when all exhibited similar void or striped patterns, whereas the word signing did not exhibit a corresponding striped pattern in the writing. Such striped patterns are caused by burrs on the ball housing and or on accumulation of fibers and other materials that build up between the ball and the housing. These burrs and or extraneous material, they cause ink to be wiped from the rotating ball during the act of writing and create a consistent pattern whilst ever the grasp of the pen remains constant. So you can see here the visuals where the fiber have been caught between the ball and the ball housing of the ballpoint pens, and due to this there is an effect on the writing which is coming. So if we go back to these words, that is meeting 2 p.m. signing when, then meeting 2 p.m. when were the original letters or words which were there by the original writer, but signing was introduced later on because it was not exhibiting the corresponding striped pattern which was otherwise there in the meeting 2 p.m. and when words. So this type of analysis can be done, and you can find out that yes, what part has been added and whether there is some malafide intention, whether it has been really done for a intention which could, that this particular document can be put up in the fraud document category, that is, it has been a fraudulent alteration. Coming to interlineation. Interlineations are defined as the writing between the lines of any instrument for the purpose of adding to it or correcting what has been written. In examining the interlineations, the tint or color of ink, quality of pen, the size of the letters, sequence of crossing the strokes, and the parts of letter which come in contact with the original written letters should be minutely studied. The fraudulent entries are likely to differ from the original or immediately adjacent writing in terms of their size or the slant or the spacing and also the shade of the ink. Even if it is a same color ink, then the shade will vary and you can examine that. Coming to sheet insertion. It is generally found that the public documents and accounts books or the bahi khatas of the factories or offices are changed by insertion of extra or the substituted pages. Now, in such cases, the paper should be examined with regard to its color and shade, the thickness, calendar, and watermark. Secondly, the ink of the writing can also be observed under a microscope to find out whether it is the altered document or the original one. And thirdly, the line to line space of the line should be compared if the papers are ruled ones. Because if you have one sheet having some particular distance between the different lines or the rules, then obviously if there is a page inserted, it is very likely that the spacing between these is differing here. So all these minute observations are required to examine such cases. The system of binding, that is how that particular booklet is bound, if it is damaged, that will also serve the purpose of detecting the fraudulent substitution of the leaves inside. The removal of a page from any document and substitution by another in its place containing matter having different meaning from that of the page removed is definitely a kind of a fraud. The substituted page may have similar appearance of the color of the paper and its composition may be different from other pages of the book. So just don't go by the color. The color may be same, but you can then analyze the composition. The composition, if it is different of that particular page, definitely it is a case of alteration. If the substituted document is written by pen and ink, the examination and comparison of the color or tint of the ink and pen and the characters of the letter will definitely reveal that it is a forgery. If the inserted sheet is a typed matter, that is not written by hand but it is a proper typed or printed matter, the fraud may be exposed by the shape, size and design of the type. The typewriting may reveal that a different type of machine was used for doing that particular printing. So when you are analyzing whether it is the edition done of that particular paper, you can do all these minute comparisons with the otherwise bulk of the sheets available in that particular bound document. Now let us come to overwriting. The overwriting may be genuine or fraudulent. Sometimes in order to correct a spelling mistake, to make writing or figures more legible, or to correct or change some writing, the same writer may overwrite the strokes or lines. This is something very common. Such overwriting are generally made boldly and no attempt is made to conceal the overwritten or overwriting, which is the habit of a writer. So the strokes are drawn carelessly. But when we come to the fraudulent overwriting, the fraudulent overwriting is aiming to change the contents of the document and is usually made in a careful manner. And every effort is made by the preparator to conceal such changes made by him or her. When the original writing instrument and or ink are not available, the preparator tries to match the color of inks and nature of stroke to the original ones. So this you have to keep in mind, because then analyzing these changes will give you a hint and you will be able to examine whether that particular document has been altered by overwriting. However, mostly he or she is not aware of the fact that the inks, though they may be of the same color, are not always the same, and they may differ considerably in their dye or pigment composition, all the details you have studied in the details of ink. So you as forensic scientist can analyze all these minute changes in the ink, that is whether the same ink has been used or a different ink has been used. And another thing is, you have to always keep in mind whether those changes done are really changing the meaning of that document or not. So that is another giving and that is another hint you are getting, that whether it is really a fraud or no. Now coming to cases related to overwriting, let us look at some examples so that you are more aware where the overwriting is being used. Fraudulent overwriting, they are generally found in some of these cases that we will discuss. Firstly, when the figures or words are changed to raise their value. For example, figure 1 can be easily changed into 7. Figure 3 can be easily changed into 8, 6 into 16, or even 26 or 36, and so on. The preparator may also overwrite the remaining figure or word of the entry so that the tint of ink may appear the same and the difference of ink may not be detected. So you have to carefully look at these components. Another thing, when the entire writing or part of the document are overwritten to conceal fraudulent additions, which are made with the ink having different shades other than the original writing. So this again will give you hint that there has been fraudulent addition. When a writer wants to disguise his or her signature or writing, he or she may overwrite letters to conceal their original writing. Another example can be, or another case can be, like when pencil or carbon outlines are converted to a traced forgery. And sometimes overwriting is purposely done to make the original writing unfit for comparison or to conceal the original writing characteristics. So these are some of the cases we discussed, and yes, it can be carefully analyzed. You have to just keep all these things in mind while analyzing such documents. Coming to examination of overwriting, most of the overwriting can be detected by examining the document carefully under direct light or by oblique light and transmitted light to find out any overlapping and change intensity of the strokes. And under the low power microscope, you can again analyze this to detect the careful joining, how it has been done, traces of original ink beneath the overwritten stroke, and also for differentiating the inks. Sometimes an examination with ultraviolet rays, IR rays, and using different color filters may also prove useful for this purpose. The examiner should never forget to examine the backside of the document, because overwriting are usually made cautiously by applying heavy pen pressure, and this causes embossing on the back of the paper, which may help a lot to reveal the truth. So in the entire document, you can come to know where the corrections have been done very carefully, because if the original writer is doing the correction, then he or she will do it casually, like the entire other part of the document has been written. But the one where it is a fraudulent document, then that particular person will be definitely doing it more carefully and putting more pressure unknowingly. And in that way, when you examine the backside of the paper, most of the times you will get the clue that yes, this is the area where, if you turn back now, you will come to know that this particular part of the document has been altered. So, dear students, let us now summarize what we have studied in this particular module. In this module, where we have studied the alteration in document and focusing on how the addition or overwriting can do the alteration, we have gone into various details and what as forensic scientists you have to keep in mind while examining such cases. We learned that any change to a document which gives it a different effect from that it originally possessed is defined as alteration in documents. Alteration in documents can be classified in different categories such as addition, interlineation, or overwriting, and we discuss both of these cases. When we talk about addition, addition is referred to the insertion of either a sentence or a word or a letter to the small space left between the line or the letters which were originally there on that particular document. Addition in the document can be performed in many ways. A sheet insertion is also a type of addition in which a new sheet, entire new sheet is attached to the whole document. And this could have the impact on changing the meaning of the entire document. The fraudulent overwriting we studied is done to change the contents of document that are usually made in careful manner. And we also studied that overwriting in documents can be examined by oblique light or UV light or IR light. And we also noticed that examining the backside of the document is very important because it will also give you clue, because wherever the writer who has changed rather than the original writer, then he or she would have used more pressure where the alteration is done, and that will be really reflected on the backside of the paper. So, dear students, I am sure that after going through this module, you will be now able to examine the cases where there have been alteration in documents, and especially dealing with the additions or overwriting cases.